Welcome to Bloomers in the Garden. I'm Len Schroeder.
And I'm Julio Zamora.
Recently, Julio and I attended the MANTS trade show in Baltimore. Okay. So what is MANTS? Mid-Atlantic Nurseryman's Trade Show. M-A-N-T-S. Get it? So we're going to share with you what were our impressions during this large event in our first segment.
For 25 years, the Pantone Color of the Year has influenced fashion, interior design, product design, branding, marketing, and even plants. This year, the Pantone Color of the Year is peach fuzz. Hear all about it during our second segment.
During our visit to MANTS, we were on the hunt for new plants and new trends. Hear what we found during our third segment.
While at the nursery show, we spoke with, guess what, a popular rose grower and hybridizer, too, about the rose rosette virus. Hear all about it during our fourth segment.
What are you reading? During the wintertime, it's a little slow, so we catch up on our literary endeavors. I have a unique excerpt from something I'm reading. Hear all about what we're reading or listening to in our final segment.
So stay tuned. We'll be right back in the garden right after these messages. Bloomers in the Garden is brought to you each week by Bloomers Home and Garden Center. Bloomers is an award-winning garden center just 20 minutes from Philadelphia. Bloomers has been providing expert advice turning brown thumbs green for over 30 years. At Bloomers, we want you to ask us every question, even if you think it's silly. We share information in a friendly, non-judgmental way that is meant to teach and spread the joy of gardening. Visit Bloomers Home and Garden Center in Washington Township, Gloucester County. For directions, go to bloomers.com, and we'll see you in the garden. Fertilome's Triple Action contains 70% neem oil and 0.25% pyrethrins as a concentrate and ready to spray. It is an insecticide, fungicide, and miticide labeled to use on vegetables, fruits, nuts, herbs, spices, and ornamentals. This organic OMRI-listed product controls a wide variety of insect pests and diseases, including aphids, scale, spider mites, white flies, rust, leaf spot, and powdery mildew. This insecticide is an all-in-one bottle that will cure just about any problem you may run into throughout the year. Fertilome's Triple Action has been helping gardeners across the country for years. Best to apply in late evening and early morning hours. Mix 1 ounce, which is equivalent to 2 tablespoons, in a gallon of water. The best part is, Triple Action may be used up to the day of harvest. So, the next time you are visiting your favorite garden center, ask for Fertilome's Triple Action and expect to have the best-looking plants in the neighborhood.
You're listening to Bloomers in the Garden Radio. Listen anytime through your favorite podcast provider or see and hear us by subscribing to Bloomers' YouTube channel. Bloomers in the Garden Radio is heard in Philadelphia and throughout the whole Delaware Valley every Saturday. First, wake up with us at 6 a.m. on WNWR The Word at 95.3 FM and 1540 AM. Tune in at 8 a.m. to Bloomers in the Garden Radio on Talk 860 WWDB. A rebroadcast of Bloomers in the Garden Radio is played each Saturday evening at 5 p.m. on The Word, 95.3 FM and 1540 AM. On Sunday at 8 a.m., we can be heard throughout the New York Tri-State Area on Classic Oldies, 1250 AM WMTR. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you in the garden. Welcome back to Bloomers in the Garden. So MANTS is the Mid-Atlantic Nurseryman's Trade Show, largest trade show for landscape plants, I think, in our industry. I mean, they do have the Northwest has some shows, and there are some, but all the other shows we go to are like hard good shows where it's like tools and fertilizer and things like this. This was mostly plants, which makes it really fun. Did you enjoy yourself at MANTS, Julio?
I did. I always do.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. What were your impressions?
Well, you know, me as a salesman all my life, when I go in there, Len, I'm looking at, okay, these guys are going to sell me something. Okay, how are you going to sell me? And I'm listening. You know?
You're listening.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I put my guard up and say, don't talk to me.
Oh, really? Well, you know, I want to see how these guys do. And, you know, as far as like, tell me something about your plants, right?
And what did, I mean, like, I thing that I noticed were actually this show, there used to be a lot of these nursery trade shows because they're put on by state organizations or like this is a region for the Mid-Atlantic. And people come as far as, you know, New England, and that it's a big deal. Mm-hmm. There used to be one in the summer called Pants. So same type of thing, Pennsylvania Nursery Trade Show. And that they stopped doing that one, but that was big. I mean, we actually wrote a lot of business at that show because our nursery orders are already in. You know, they're done. Our orders are already done. We've got our acknowledgments. And that we also have our you know, new availability to go through. So I really don't do a lot of writing at this show, but I also check out to see what's new. And when they opened the show up, rather than more, you know, it's opened up to a lot of landscapers. And you can always tell because they have matching jackets. Something I tell my folks, don't wear your bloomer stuff. This is a chance just to look nice. Anyway, it's a casual Friday, thing,
yeah,
right?
Right?
So,
yeah.
But a lot of robotics. Oh. Did you notice?
Yeah.
Did you notice?
Yeah.
So robotics have hit the nursery industry. There was this little cart that was a robotic cart. Now, I don't have any use for something like that and run over a customer.
Yeah.
But I've seen them in Sam's Club. Have you seen the floor cleaner in Sam's Club?
No, I haven't.
No?
How does that work?
No? Aaron, how about you?
At BJ's, though, they have like this robot that checks inventory.
No kidding.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
wow.
Man, my daughter saw it the other day. It was like,
Very cool.
I was confused. What were we looking at? And I thought it was doing something. It was just going across the shelves and scanning.
Wow.
It's amazing.
That. Nobody was there.
Nobody, right? It probably put somebody out of work, but.
Well, Centerton, they have this robot that goes and it spaces all the plants.
Whoa.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool to see that work, you know, where it's just like every plant is perfectly spaced.
Yeah, down to the millimeter.
And that their houses are like 600 foot long.
Goodness.
So. You know, that you gotta talk about putting people out of business. It's a monotonous task.
Sure.
It is.
But some of the stuff was very cool. You know, what as far as like product lines and plant material or whatever, what did you see let me see through your eyes.
Well, you know, Len, the one that really hit me was the star roses and shrubs where they were talking about, you know, all these different plants as far as Mahonia.
Yeah,
and a new oak leaf hydrangeas. I mean, those guys really knew how to sell them.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed
deal.
That.
They're a big deal because that was the old Connard Pyle,
uh-huh.
And that they used to sell like to guys like me, but they I don't know a long time ago they stopped selling, and all they concentrate on is new plants. So I don't know. I was a little disappointed that I didn't see more new plants. Even that Eclipse hydrangea, I didn't see that all over the place.
Yeah.
I expected to see that like every display,
yeah.
every
yeah.
turn there was that hydrangea, but it was not there.
Yeah, I saw one POP hanging up on the roof.
Yeah, but I guess they don't have to because they're probably going to be sold out.
Yeah, probably.
But again, the equipment that they had there, you know, they had trucks and mulch spreaders and they had all this kind of stuff. That was it was just cool. I felt like, you know, it was one of those Tonka trucks, you know, that you could get.
Yeah.
But again, Centerton Nursery, you know, mm-hmm. launching the whole natives.
Native thing. Yeah,
right. That was a big deal. Yeah. And Proven Winners.
Oh gosh.
We act like that a lot about Proven Winners.
Uh-huh.
And that they have become the Amazon of horticulture.
Okay? Amazon.
You know, Amazon said, you know, it's like, all right, you know, delivering like prescriptions, we can do that.
Yeah.
So they took over that. You know, they talk grocery deliveries. They took over that. Mm-hmm. You know, they look at a area that they can disrupt. They're disruptors. Proven Winners is doing the same thing. 'Cause right now it's houseplants. They're into houseplants now. We talked to Walter's Gardens that they're into, you know, perennials. They've always been into perennials and shrubs, but now it's like they're going to do bulbs. Yeah, they have a cooperative with bulb growers and bulb suppliers, Garden State Bulb, and that they're going to do something different to package bulbs or in a combination in a way that is a refresh of what you see on the shelves. Better or worse, I don't know. A lot of times it's the same darn plant. It's not anything
different.
But where it's just expanding into so many different, its tentacles are reaching everywhere. So a lot of times when we talk about proven winners, we go proven winners, you know, here they are again. You know, but they're but they're just, what they're doing is very smart.
Yeah, it is.
Very smart. So I don't know. My biggest takeaway was, the plants that are coming out are not unique enough for me. You know, it's another hydrangea, another hookah. Yeah.
The H's are again, right?
Yeah, we're still stuck in the H's.
Yeah, I do.
Right? But what you had said about the Mahonia, Mahonia, those of you that don't know, it's a shrub that can go into full shade. It takes wet areas. It has a yellow flower, and that was the difference. The flower color was different,
it was orange, yeah.
So it was an orange flower versus the traditional yellow flower, and gets a blueberry, almost like a blueberry color. Very pretty.
Very pretty. Tropical
looking. Underused. Yeah. Underused. So that was, and again, that was going to be introduced from Star Plants. I'll give that one. That one, two thumbs up. So,
good.
All right. Well, in the next segment, we're going to be talking about color, and we're going to talk about it right after these messages. Hi, this is Len Schroeder from Bloomers in the Garden. Do you have a landscape, garden, or plant question? If so, call or text us using the Bloomers in the Garden hotline. Dial 609-685-1880. That's 609-685-1880. Don't be shy. We want to hear from you. Call or text us and let us know what problems you're facing. Let us know how we're doing. Call or text 609-685-1880. If we use your comment on the air, we'll send you a free Bloomers t-shirt. Call or text us at 609-685-1880. That's 609-685-1880. And we'll see you in the garden.
Are you looking forward to a spring of vibrancy while using the best organically approved growing media for your annuals and vegetables? Coast of Maine's Sprout Island Organic Seed Starter has been created to set a diverse culture ideal for germinating seeds and root cuttings. Created using the best ancient composting techniques and new age mixing devices, Sprout Island Organic Seed Starter gently combines kelp meal, worm castings, mycorrhiza, perlite, and sustainably harvested peat moss, establishing the most desirable setting to enhance new plant growth. Coast of Maine's Sprout Island Organic Seed Starter is available at these local retailers or visit www.coastofmaine.com to locate one near you.
Pickering Valley Feed and Farm, Exton, PA. Ashcombe's Farm and Greenhouses, Mechanicsburg, PA. Sickles, Little Silver, New Jersey. Wanting to up your game in the vegetable garden? With 90 years of organic gardening experience, the Espoma Company has you covered. Espoma Organic Garden Tone is not your average garden variety fertilizer. Garden Tone is especially blended for organic vegetable gardens. Its all-natural formula contains Biotone, a blend of organic ingredients that supplies essential nutrients for strong, healthy plants and mouth-watering vegetables. Its slow-release formula provides continuous feeding. The Biotone contained in Garden Tone is a combination of organic ingredients and beneficial microbes to help roots grow deeper and faster for bigger, more bountiful harvests. Garden Tone is simple to use and safe for people, pets, and the planet. No harmful chemicals or synthetic fertilizers are ever added. You can find Garden Tone at fine garden centers. Visit Espoma.com to find a retailer near you. Garden Tone from Espoma, a natural in the garden since 1929.
Welcome back to Bloomers in the Garden. The Pantone color of the year is Peach fuzz.
Yay! Yeah. All right.
Wow.
All right. So one cool thing is that Pantone, based in New Jersey, it's called the Pantone Color Institute, best known for its forecasting for colors. And yes, it does have influences on all types of things. They've been doing this since 2000. It is peach fuzz.
You're not too happy.
All right.
Yeah, I'm already disappointed, too.
It is white person skin color. It is.
Yo, that's funny.
It's like, you know, white baby.
Maybe.
White baby color.
Yeah. I mean, when I was a kid, my dad used to say I had peach fuzz growing on my chin.
See, there you
know, like the hair that was growing out.
I think all of us got made fun of when we were trying to grow that.
Yeah.
Me, it was that Tom Selleck mustache. Didn't look anything like
that. No, not at all.
No.
I can imagine.
No. So, peach fuzz. Okay. What does it mean to me? White person's skin. What does it mean to Pantone? Now listen to this. Ready? Subtly sensual, Pantone 13-1023 Peach Fuzz is a heartfelt peach hue, bringing a feeling of tenderness and communicating a message of caring and sharing, community and collaboration.
Wow.
All right.
It's quite a mouthful there, Pantone.
Oh, they're not done.
They're not done?
No, because it's a symbiotic relationship between our sense of taste, sight, touch, and scent.
Wow.
Did AI come with that?
Right? Probably. Probably. AI in action. There's probably somebody who's gets paid money to write that
stuff. That's very thoughtful. to say the least.
You know, we're a radio podcast program, and it's hard to show you colors, but it is like...
It's actually going to right there on the bottom left-hand corner of your screen for our YouTube listeners.
Right. And please subscribe. Right there. I like if... Now, there are some dahlias that are this color flower, and it's like a faded... peach. It's not even a good peach. It's a faded peach. And that I could see it in a dress. I could see it in a paint color. I mean, not in my house, but maybe like baby's room or something. I don't know. Would you paint any room in your house this color?
Nah, probably accent. I wouldn't do a whole room this color.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's going to be like, first thing I thought about is like notebooks. Like, a notebook color, like to, you know, bring to school. Yes. Sure. Backpack. Yes.
Sure.
Dress. Absolutely. I can see it being used, but the plant world, I think they missed this one. The magenta last year was screaming. That was nice. That definitely was used. And we go back to dahlias again. Dahlias have such a wide range of colors. And that, again, that, there is this peach fuzz color in dahlias, but I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know. They have all of these things that they've given us for descriptions. Let's see. It says cultural reference. Peachy tones have been used in art and design for centuries. In Chinese culture, peach blossoms symbolize longevity and good luck. In Western culture, peaches are often associated with summer and warmth. The Pantone Color Institute choice of peach fuzz for the 2024 color of the year reflects the current cultural climate of the need for human connection and nurturing.
Wow. Pretty heavy stuff.
Okay. There's psychological effects to this color.
Yeah.
The color psychology suggests that peach tones have a calming effect on the mind and body.
It does.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I think so.
All right. Do you like your escape room? You know?
Yeah.
Anyway, the soft, warm hue of peach fuzz can invoke feelings of comfort and relaxation.
Yes.
This color can also promote compassion and empathy, which aligns with the Pantone Color Institute message of human connection. Wow. Color theory and context, peach fuzz is a muted shade of orange associated with joy, creativity, and enthusiasm.
Wow.
This color also complements blue, often associated with calmness and stability. I love blue. Blue is my favorite color.
Oh, yeah.
So if you're, you know, ever buying me something,
right.
Blue is it. I'm terrible. I mean, I have bought the same blue shirt.
Really?
Yeah, I get home, it's like, I already have this stupid shirt. Blue. Yes, blue. I'm stuck on blue. When used in design and branding, peach fuzz can convey a sense of approachability and warmth.
Oh, yeah.
Applications and influence, Pantone Color of the Year, Peach Fuzz is a color that was Signal Flight influence in many areas of design, fashion, interior design, product design, branding, and marketing. So get ready to see Peach Fuzz on ads. Start looking for Peach Fuzz. You definitely, you know who uses this kind of stuff all the time is all of those drug commercials that clog your TV and your computer. Anyway, fashion, it's a great color. Let's see. So fashion industry, peach, and this is from Pantone. Fashion industry, peach fuzz is a beautiful color used in the fashion industry to create a sense of warmth and comfort. This is color is perfect for apparel and textile design, especially for creating cozy and tactile fabrics, which can be worn all seasons. Peach fuzz is a versatile color that can be used in various styles from casual to formal. I saw it looks like a prom dress that they were showing with it. And it looked really good.
Good, huh?
It looked really good.
Yeah. Starting to warm up to it, huh?
If I ever need a prom dress. interior design. The color peach fuzz is a great interior design for home decor. Maybe. This color is ideal in any room of the house because it gives off a cozy, welcoming vibe. In addition to looking great with softer hues like beige, cream, and light blue. There's that blue again. How about we just go to light blue? Peach fuzz can also make striking contrast with darker shades. Now, how it's been like so many years with grays. I mean, like the house is neutral color, painted gray. You know, painted a gray color, dark gray, light gray, charcoal gray. Maybe we can get some color in our world. I'd be up with that. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I want my house painted peach fuzz.
Yeah,
I don't know. Yeah. Anyway,
whole house?
No, not outside.
Inside.
We had
the shutters might look nice with the peach fuzz though.
Mr. Weiss is a customer of Boomers, and I haven't seen him for a while. But he went to Princeton,
okay,
and he painted his house the Princeton colors.
Oh man,
orange.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty hot.
Yeah.
Real hot.
Princeton orange is hot.
Yeah, he owns the Green Tree Tobacco Company.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he sells cigars. Neighbors.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That's pretty awesome.
Okay, let's see. Product design. Peach fuzz is a versatile color used in the consumer goods sector to create functional and stylish products. This color is perfect for creating tactile and visual appealing effects. Peach fuzz is a color used to make various products from the kitchen appliances. Now, I can see that. Like, you know, your mixer, your standable mixer, where it's got, I can see that. To tech gadgets. I don't know about that. I guess. Your iPhone and peach fuzz.
Phone case.
Would your daughter like that?
Yeah,
as a case, maybe.
Yeah.
I wouldn't buy her one with
a peach fuzz
phone, though.
Rose gold?
Yeah, nah.
No?
We get to stick with the black and the white and the grays.
Basic.
Yeah.
Branding and marketing. Definitely, it's going to be in marketing. Peach fuzz conveys because of the whole coziness and comfort thing. The color scheme is ideal for developing a dependable and approachable brand. Peach fuzz can be used to create a variety of marketing collateral, such as packaging and logos. Wow.
Collateral.
Collateral. Peach fuzz is collateral.
Right, yeah. Yes. The terms they use.
Well, and I tell you, it's unfortunately, I think that we're the horticultural industry, as far as a flower goes.
Limited?
Yeah, I don't know. What do you think?
I think it's limited.
Well, come on, defend your position.
It's a cool color, not, you know,
cool as in interesting or cool as in temperature?
Cool as temperature, yeah. So, you know, I don't like cool colors in my home.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you don't think it's warm on the spectrum?
I don't know. It doesn't hit me. You know, it doesn't. Yeah, I like, you know, purples. I like it more vibrant.
Yeah.
You know, us Latins, you know.
Well, there you go. That's good. You should see what he's wearing. Right. You can go to YouTube, our YouTube channel, and subscribe right here. There's so many things with colors that we don't even think of. Like for instance, if you have a waiting room where you want people to relax and you go slow, then you paint it that like this color or have parts of it so people relax and they don't mind waiting. If you have an area where you want people to get out, you know, move them out, you use red. Red's like, you know, you want to get out of that room. So if you notice, we did a whole study one time where I took the whole crew and we went through this is a long time when there was a mall. Sam, a mall is a place where you would go shopping and that you'd buy things. Okay.
I'm from South Jersey, Len. Don't worry. We got plenty of
dead malls. Malls. So anyway, this is when malls were actually, there was a reason to go. Boy, that's not very nice. But what we did is we went and we looked at floor coloring, lighting. We looked at the colors that each one was painted, and Nordstrom's was our big study. So anyway, pay attention next time you're having a shopping experience or in an upscale place, and look at the colors they choose. Peach fuzz.
Yes, sir.
I don't know. Jury's out.
Yes, it is.
If you can find, I tell you what, on a rose, it might not be bad.
Yeah, rose would look good.
But still. Yeah. You know, this is radio and podcast. If you can, it is the white baby color.
It is.
I don't.
You heard it here first.
That's more like pink, man. Pinkish kind of. This is, to me, it's very warm, right? But
yeah.
It's just, it doesn't seem like
it
should be a
primary. White babies aren't warm?
I'm just saying, like, especially when they cry, man, they get a little bit more pink than they do, like, this orangey kind of.
They do absolutely get pink.
You know what I mean? Versus this orangish kind of peach kind of. It's in the middle for me.
Yeah.
It's in the middle.
I mean, you're a color guy. So yeah. You do all of our marketing.
Yeah. I wouldn't put it as a primary color.
Yeah.
I would use it as an accent. Right, yeah,
like a border around something that's kind of weak.
Absolutely, it's a border.
Yeah, you think?
Yeah,
it's not enough of a contrast to something else.
I mean, if the navy blue would be a nice contrast, the blue and all of that, but I would still use that as a primary. You know what I mean? Like, I just not sold on this being. I mean, no against the Pantone, right? Don't send me any hate mail. Forward it to Julio Zamora.
All hate mail goes to Julio Zamora.
But I'm just not sold on it being something as a primary.
Do you see? Do you see it more like a feminine type of color?
Or no? I do.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
You know what color it is?
What's that?
It is the old Tampa Bay Buccaneers uniform colors.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
I know.
I'm not that old. I don't even know what they are. All I knew was red. Red and black and gold.
When Tampa Bay first came into the league, they had peach fuzz colored jerseys.
Oh, my God.
Look it up.
That would be cool.
Well, while you're looking that up, we're going to break. We'll be right back right after this. Fertilome Succulent Potting Mix with EcoPeat is the perfect ready-to-use potting mix for all your succulents. Fertilome Succulent Potting Mix is a blend of sphagnum peat moss, perlite, and EcoPeat. EcoPeat is a natural wood fiber from peat bogs. When added to Fertilome peat moss, it produces a superior professional substrate with an exceptional ratio of air porosity and water holding capacity. Fertilome Succulent Potting Mix will ensure maximum drainage with ideal water retention. It's simply the best succulent mix on the market. Ask for Fertilome by name at your local garden center. Available at Daniel's Garden Center, Sumneytown Pike, Harleysville, Pennsylvania. Gasper's Home and Garden, 316 Tanyard Road, Richboro, PA.
Dreaming of a gorgeous garden? Give your azaleas, rhododendron, blueberries, and evergreens a powerful boost with the number one acid-loving plant food, Espoma Organic Hollytone. Hollytone is a perfect blend of natural, long-lasting ingredients that nourish plants for stronger roots, faster growth, and bountiful blooms.
Plus, it's easy to use and safe for people, pets, and planet. Visit Espoma.com for a retailer near you and helpful gardening tips. Espoma, a natural in the garden since 1929.
If you're like me, then you absolutely love birds. The Bird Sanctuary at Bloomers Home and Garden Center has you covered. They're dedicated to the care and feeding of wild birds of all sorts. Want to bring more birds to your yard? Then you got to see this place. Bloomers has a huge flock of feeders, birdhouses, birdseed, and much, much more. Want to feed the birds and not the squirrels? They have this absolutely cool bronze bird feeder that will drive those sneaky squirrels nuts. They'll be moving to the next door neighbor in no time. OMG. Bloomers have these absolutely adorable birdhouses that will turn your yard into the perfect bird B&B. They carry all types of wild bird seed, suet, seed cakes, and mealworms. Bloomers stocks, Lyric, Kohl's, CNS, Pine Tree Farms, and much, much more that will keep those beautiful birds coming back for more. Bloomers Home and Garden Center is located in Washington Township in Gloucester County. For more information and directions, check them out on the web at bloomers.com. Bloomers Home and Garden Center, you got to see this place.
Welcome back to Bloomers in the Garden. You know, when we were at the Mant Show, we're always looking for new plant introductions and trends. And a couple of weeks ago, we did something about the boxwood blight that's occurring. And we saw boxwoods all over the place that were, they were bred to be resistant to the boxwood blight. One of those boxwoods is something called better boxwoods, and that you'll be able to see them at a garden center near you pretty soon, because it's distinctive offerings that it's all about the boxwood blight and how it's resistant. And good thing is that they've done a lot of testing on this. In England is where this first popped up, and that you can picture the English gardens with all of those boxwood hedges and things where they went and they took them, and they've done a lot of the research has been done there, and they're bringing it across the pond over to us.
That's great.
So again, it's called Better Boxwoods. They're going to be the standard looking boxwood. They look very similar. I mean, everybody wants that English boxwood. You have, you know, dwarf English boxwood, and that somebody's got to capture that name in one of the newer varieties. Our friends over at Centerton Nursery, Bobby Blue.
There you go.
We talked with Bobby for a while, and Tim Bloxham, and that we were talking about their new initiative on natives.
Wow.
You know, you've heard us talk about nativars and things. What they're doing is they're going after a segment of the market where there are true hardcore naturalists that only want natives. And those are the original plants, the original form that is not really been adapted to anything better. I can't hide my whole thing. I hate natives. But again, natives natives have their place.
Yeah,
they're called weeds. Oh, I'm gonna send your hate mail to Julio Zamora. Care of
I'll probably get plenty of them.
So again, it's going to be easier to find. So rather than having to do your research before you go, Centerton has made it easy so that you can find it because they're labeled and branded as natives, and that it's a marketing campaign on their part to actually get it to the masses. I applaud them on that. Here we go. Proven winners. Here we go. Walter's Gardens is a Michigan grower and hybridizer that has, I guess, partnered with Proven Winners. And this isn't so much a, I can't say it's a new plant, although they do have some new plants coming out with Proven Winners. But what I liked is that, you know how the Proven Winner annuals have that recipe on how to create a combo basket? They took that to Easyscapes and they call it Easyscape's recipe program, and it's a combination of anywhere between 3 to 5 to 7 perennials that will create easy and elegant landscapes, and they're all different ones. You know, I know that they have probably about 10 different varieties, and that your proven winter garden centers that are, you know, you're not going to find it at Lowe's, but you're going to find it at your independent garden center, and that we have a program where we become a certified proven winter garden center, and that we'll have things like this, and it'll be recipe cards to basically show you where to plant things, how to put them in the ground, what to do, and that it's nice because a lot of people don't know, and especially perennials, right?
Yeah. They have all the time.
It's like, I don't know. Because it takes into account the fact that when they bloom, where they grow, and gives the selection so everything looks good. Good. And I saw the other ones. Did you see these, Will? The butterfly candy buddleia.
No, I didn't see those.
All right. Really impressed. Yeah, I mean, really. I love Pugsters. Mm. Pugsters are an incredible plant. Just got some other award as being the best plant ever someplace in some other country. I can't remember which one right now. But the butterfly candy buddleia only gets to about 2 to 3 foot tall. 2 to 3 foot.
That's it.
That's tiny.
It is.
Regular standard buddleia can get to be almost 8 foot. Yeah. We had some white ones that were 8 foot tall and in front of our displays. We had to cut the thing down. But where these only get 2 to 3 feet tall and lots of different colors from pink to blue to purple white to magenta. And they just are a fantastic plant. So look for butterfly candy buddleia at a garden center this coming spring.
That's going to be great.
It is. And 2 to 3 foot. Think about that. Oh, yeah. A buddleia 2 to 3 foot. Full-size flowers now. Mm-hmm. Full-size flowers.
Wow.
But, again, it's a compact habit. Mm-hmm. It's 2 to 3 foot tall and wide. And they can adapt to small spaces. Mm-hmm. And also, ready?
Yeah.
Containers.
In
a pot, you know, attracting butterflies and things. I like it.
Yep.
I like it. So that's butterfly candy buddleia. Mm-hmm.
Wonderful.
All right. We'll be back in the garden right after this. Hi, this is Len Schroeder from Bloomers in the Garden. Do you have a landscape, garden, or plant question? If so, call or text us using the Bloomers in the Garden hotline. Dial 609-685-1880. That's 609-685-1880. Don't be shy. We want to hear from you. Call or text us and let us know what problems you're facing. Let us know how we're doing. Call or text 609-685-1880. If we use your comment on the air, we'll send you a free Bloomers t-shirt. Call or text us at 609-685-1880. That's 609-685-1880. And we'll see you in the garden. Fertilome Succulent Potting Mix with EcoPeat is the perfect ready-to-use potting mix for all your succulents. Fertilome Succulent Potting Mix is a blend of sphagnum peat moss, perlite, and EcoPeat. EcoPeat is a natural wood fiber from peat bogs. When added to Fertilome peat moss, it produces a superior professional substrate with an exceptional ratio of air porosity and water-holding capacity. Fertilome Succulent Potting Mix will ensure maximum drainage with ideal water retention. It's simply the best succulent mix on the market. Ask for Fertilome by name at your local garden center. Available at Daniels Garden Center, Sumneytown Pike, Harleysville, Pennsylvania. Gasper's Home and Garden, 316 Tanyard Road, Richboro, PA. Your next houseplant is waiting for you in Bloomers Home and Garden Center's greenhouse. Bloomers recognizes that houseplant choices are as important to your interior decorating as the fabric on your couch. The right plant paired with the perfect container can bring a dynamic change to your home. A houseplant brings life to your world and connects your home's interior to the greater outdoors. Even a small succulent placed on your coffee table has a way of connecting your living room to the Amazon rainforest. How about an air plant in your kitchen? Looking for an indoor flowering plant to add color to your plant palette? Bloomers has a large revolving assortment of flowering beauties. From aglaonemas to zizi plants, Bloomers Greenhouse is stocked with your next favorite indoor plant. Bloomers carries a large selection of pottery and containers to match your home's decor and make any of your plants more beautiful. Bloomers experts can help you care for your plants and have the fertilizer, insecticides, leaf shine, and specialty soils you need to grow healthy and happy indoor plants. Visit Bloomers Home and Garden Center's greenhouse and make every room in your home a living room. Visit bloomers.com for more information. That's bloomers.com, and we'll see you in the garden.
Welcome back to Bloomers in the Garden. Rose Rosette is a rose virus with no known cure, spread by a mite that's main host is on wild roses. Or is it?
It used to be.
Yeah.
It used to be. Okay, so the whole virus that we're talking about, Rose Rosette, is something that can't be cured. But it's carrier, so something gets into the rose and spreads it. So how does it spread? It spreads through an insect, a mite, microscopic, tiny, tiny mite. And that the disease really started back, you know, the first time I guess it was seen is in the 40s.
Way back.
But they didn't know until like 2011 that it's actually a virus, not the mite. And the mite, listen, this mite is tiny. You can barely see it. I don't even know if you can see it, like with a handheld like magnifying glass.
Can't see
it. Is tiny. And this is how tiny it is. It doesn't fly, but it can float on a breeze and go from plant to plant.
Amazing.
So it's not, you know, it's not where it's flying from plant to plant. The key is killing the mite. And that's where I want to put Bloomers and Bloomers in the Garden's efforts into spraying your roses. I mean, roses used to be hybrid tea roses and grandifloras and floribundas. And what it was is you would grow the rose mostly for the flower. So you would have individual varieties, not hedges of knockout roses. And this was what we were talking about with one of the hybridizers. And I don't want to start anything, but it seems to be that now knockout roses are a carrier of the mites are there. They get Rose Rosette. And it was sitting in the parking lot at ShopRite. You know, I was waiting in the car. And I'm looking, and in front of me was where there once was when the shopping center was either built or whatever, fixed up. It was a row of knockout roses. And that must have been beautiful when they first went in. Now, all gnarled growth, and this is how you know whether you have it, that it had the new growth was a reddish color, stunted, like a witch's broom. A witch's broom is where it looks like it has been pruned really, really heavy. And a lot of dead growth, a lot of dead growth. And it's a bad thing. It's a bad thing because it used to be that it was only on wild roses. So like if you could keep the rosette under control by controlling the insect, but people would spray for disease, and it would be a waste of time. So what they need to do is they need to spray and make that plant poisonous to that mite. But if, say, Aaron, you know dogs.
Yes. Yep. Absolutely.
So if a dog has rabies and if it's dead, you can still contract the rabies disease, right?
Most definitely. Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
You can still get rabies. And this is the rose rosette disease. If that mite bites into the rose and dies, it still can inject that virus into that plant.
So can I ask you a question? Yep. For, I guess, the less experienced gardeners who want to plant roses, what type of precautions should you go to beforehand, before you put them in the ground?
In the Wayback Machine, we used to tell people who bought roses, you're going to have to spray.
Right.
And at this point, I think we're at the point where we stopped telling people they had to spray when we selling shrub roses.
Right.
I think we have to say that you need to spray and get on a spray program, and it's just the way it is. It's just the way it is. Not everybody will do it.
Right.
But the people that do will have better roses, and that there'll be more longevity.
Yeah. Keep those mites down.
Yeah, sure. to keep the mites out.
Got it.
And I think that that's what we should do. But, you know, we're going to alienate a whole classification of plants that were like landscape plants. I don't know. It concerns me because we sell a lot of knockout roses.
Yes, we do.
It's like when you see a whole hedge like this where it's infected and, you know, 3/4 of them are dead. Not good. Mm-hmm. Not good.
You know, Len, this past year we had 2 customers come in and had that problem.
Yeah.
Before that, you know, I never heard of it. Anybody coming in with that problem. So,
well, a lot of times it was misdiagnosed.
That's probably what it was, huh?
Yeah, it's misdiagnosed. Yeah. But, you know, we're up on these things, you know. like, again, you can't plant them too close. Mm-hmm. You need to prune them and keep them fed. You're trying to outgrow some of the disease, I guess. You need to cut the plants back. And here's one of the biggest things is that when it defoliates, you need to get all those leaves up. Don't leave them there for a number of reasons. It's not just from Rosette, but it's also for the other diseases roses can get. Just clean up those leaves and take them away. The mite is difficult to control. I'm going to tell you, it's going to be better controlled from a contact spray than using like a systemic insecticide, where systemics are always my rose go-to, but where a contact spray is going to be better. Predatory mites, you know, you release the thing that eats it. So, I mean, that's, you think about, and I don't want people to let their guard down, but the spotted lanternfly, you know, wasn't that big a deal. It wasn't as big a deal as it was, say, 2 or 3 years ago. And that's because I think that the natural predators are starting to eat them. There's that picture that's out there on the internet that shows a praying mantis, you know, half chomped down on a spotted lanternfly. And that's what, you know, I think there's other insects that are doing the same thing. So they're trying to breed varieties. And again, this is where the science comes in. They're trying to breed varieties so that they don't, that they are resistant, that they're roses that are resistant. But so far, I mean, they said, you know, that they used the term resistant back when knockouts came out. Just like, oh, they're resistant to it. But we talked to the company that is the hybridizer for knockouts, and they didn't really have much to say.
So Len, you know, when you're saying a spray program, we might have to let the customer know that they should use maybe multiple products.
Right.
Rather than just one.
Right. Off and on.
Off and on kind of thing.
Yep. You know, use a dormant oil spray or use a insecticidal soap, or using some neem oil or the neem soap or something like that. Right. And that will help. Right. You know, we're going to have segments when the growing season starts all about this.
Right.
So, mm-hmm. All right. What are you reading? We're going to let you know what we're reading when we get back right after this. You know, some of our most frequent questions revolve around organic container gardening for houseplants, annuals, and of course, vegetables. Coast of Maine's Bar Harbor Blend Organic Potting Soil is a lightweight soil mixture made with salmon, blueberry, lobster, and other compost, as well as calcium and chitin-rich lobster shells, sphagnum peat, perlite, and kelp meal. It is a great soil. And Coast of Maine's Bar Harbor Organic Potting Soil is rich in organic material, creating lush, disease-resistant plants that require less watering, less feeding. Its rich, dark brown color provides the perfect balance between water retention and drainage needed for healthy plants. Coast of Maine's Bar Harbor Blend Organic Potting Soil is available at these local retailers. Barlow's, Seagirt, New Jersey. Espenshade's Garden Centers and Greenhouse, Monton, Pennsylvania. Ashcombe's Farm and Greenhouse, Mechanicsburg, PA.
Dreaming of a gorgeous garden? Give your azaleas, rhododendron, blueberries, and evergreens a powerful boost with the number one acid-loving plant food, Espoma Organic Hollytone. Hollytone is a perfect blend of natural, long-lasting ingredients that nourish plants for stronger roots, faster growth, and bountiful blooms. Plus, it's easy to use and safe for people, pets, and planet. Visit Espoma.com for a retailer near you and helpful gardening tips. Espoma, a natural in the garden since 1929.
Are you looking to reach an audience of over 12 million residents in the Philadelphia, Delaware Valley, and New York City Tri-State? Then consider becoming a broadcast sponsorship partner for Bloomers in the Garden. Every week on Bloomers in the Garden Radio, your products become associated with the authority in everything lawn, landscape, and garden. For more information on the Bloomers in the Garden Partnership Program, feel free to call the hotline, 609-685-1880, or check out the radio tab at bloomers.com.
Welcome back to Bloomers in the Garden. Well, you know, this is our slower time, and we often are reading something. It's interesting. I'm reading something. Julio, are you reading anything?
Yeah.
What are you reading?
I'm reading a biography by a woman, Amy Carmichael.
Okay. Yeah. Who's Amy Carmichael?
She's dead already. She was an English. yeah, I know.
It's okay. A lot of people do.
I know. She was a missionary in India.
Okay. Yep. Interesting.
Orphanage.
Aaron, you read something.
Yeah, I'm reading this book called The Garden Within.
What's the gist?
I think the tagline is like where the war with your emotions ends or something like that. It's heavy.
You need some peach fuzz.
It's heavy, but it's a New York Times bestseller.
Yeah,
it's pretty good. Really? Yeah. Yeah, it's by a lady named Dr. Anita Phillips.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Wow.
Well, I got caught off guard where I'm reading this book and it's an autobiography and it's really good. And that I got to where it's like all of a sudden he starts talking about his love of gardening. I was like, hey, right up my alley. You know? He was saying like in his house, like they had, and just we're talking about roses the last segment, you know. I mean, it's pretty cool. He said that he had all of these roses, and these are like my roses, going back to like hybrid teas and stuff, where he had Elizabeth Taylor, Double Delight, and he used to raise all these things. And it's funny because of the house that he had these roses planted, and this is an actor, and that he sold the house to Andy Garcia.
Oh, how about that?
Right? But the stipulation was that he had to leave the rose garden. He couldn't take the rose garden. One of the things that that he put, he's saying there's just something about putting your hands in the dirt and it takes your mind away from every day. And we talk about that all the time. But the thing that really struck me is that he had an aunt who in Nazi Germany, to smuggle herself out, she smuggled herself out in a coffin. But along with herself, she brought her spider plant. And all of the friends and family, once she got to New York, all of the Jewish community around her got cuttings from this plant, including the author that I'm talking about. You don't usually think of this guy with gardening. Yeah. And the book that I'm reading is called Being Henry, The Fonds and Beyond by Henry Winkler. Hang on, Henry Winkler's a gardener? He loves it. But it just shows that, you know, gardening touches so many people. And that, but to think that she brought her, and that he has those same plants today.
Still.
So we're talking, when was it, 30s?
30s, yeah.
And then she smuggled it out in a coffin, and here it's part of the family and the whole community. And Aaron, you're from up there. There's a solid the Jewish community in New York is, you know, they've been through it, man.
For sure.
And that where here they have cuttings of these spider plants everywhere. Proven Winners is going to call them. Yeah. Hey, we need a copy. We need a
need one of those.
We're going to market this anyway. But I just think it's interesting that that was in the book. And that
were the coffins wooden back then? Because
I'm sure.
Yeah, because I mean the newer coffins, I thought they were like airtight and sealed and all that.
Well, they're supposed to be. I mean, I don't know. It depends,
man.
You know, it depends. You can cover a coffin pretty good.
Yeah. You know? I don't know, man.
You can paint it peach fuzz.
Right?
You know?
That's crazy.
Yeah. All right. We're going to be right back and finish up right after this.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. Put your
slant. Hi, this is Len Schroeder from Bloomers in the Garden. Do you have a landscape, garden, or plant question? If so, call or text us using the Bloomers in the Garden hotline. Dial 609-685-1880. That's 609-685-1880. Don't be shy. We want to hear from you. Call or text us and let us know what problems you're facing. Let us know how we're doing. Call or text 609-685-1880. If we use your comment on the air, we'll send you a free Bloomers t-shirt. Call or text us at 609-685-1880. That's 609-685-1880. And we'll see you in the garden. Coast of Maine's Organic Castine Blend Organic Raised Bed Mix is the best soil for raised bed gardens, planter boxes, and container gardens. It grows amazing vegetables. It is made with a mixture of manure compost, worm castings, lobster and kelp meal, mycorrhiza, green sand, and biochar. It's ready to use straight out of the bag with no need for additional components or tilling. If you love growing fresh and hearty vegetables, herbs, and flowers, Coast of Maine's Castine Blend Organic Raised Bed Mix is the perfect choice for you. At Coast of Maine, we believe in growing organically and buying locally. Castine Organic Raised Bed Mix can be found at these fine stores.
Pickering Valley Feed and Farm, Exton, Pennsylvania. Ashcombe Farm and Greenhouses, Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania. Tony's Farm and Garden, Windsor, New Jersey.
Me and Julio. Lots to learn. The Mance Show was an education.
Yeah.
It was amazing. Fun.
Yeah, it was
fun. Cool. They're Coast of Maine, brand new indoor plant soil.
Oh, great.
Indoor plant soil.
Wonderful.
So look for that.
Yeah, a lot of new things coming out of Holland. Huh, beautiful stuff, you know. The Puxer line of, what's that one, candy?
Yeah.
Oh, that's going to be awesome.
Yeah. So, all right, we're going to be here next week, the same time. Please call us with your gardening houseplant questions, and that we'll answer them. What you do is you leave a message. We'll get back to you on our hotline at 609-685-1880. We'll see you in the garden.
See you in the garden.